Good morning. So we are back to our consideration of the geometry, Erlangen approach to geometry which can be obtained from the group SL to R. So at early stage we identify the collection, invariant collection of objects under Möbius transformation. It was cycles. And on the previous lecture, we find a way of representing these cycles in different form. So analytically, cycles are given by certain quadratic equation, a homogeneous one, and the coefficients of this homogeneous quadratic equation for real number up to homogeneity condition represent a point in three-dimensional projective space. And for some reason, we said what it will be good to have two times two matrices which represent such a cycle. And these matrices contain one more imaginary unit, brief iota, which describe certain inner geometry, geometry which is not immediately visible probably on the point space, but represent a relation between cycle in the space of cycle, three-dimensional projective space. So that was our different representation for cycle, is a three-dimensional projective space or a certain quadratic equation on the point space or the collection of two times two matrices, again, given up to projective relation. And in connection to this projective relation, we define two type of normalization. Normalization which make parameter k equal to 1 if it was non-zero, or normalization which make determinant of two times two matrix equal to determinant of two times two matrix equal to 1. So at least one of this normalization shall work for any cycle, but there are cycles such what is a k equal to 0 or determinant equal to 0, so they cannot be normalized by that corresponding representation. So important property which we observed is that cycles make a vector, projective vector space. So it's reasonable to consider linear combination of cycles. And with linear combination of cycles are classically represented by pencil of circles in inversive geometry. So you may look to the wonderful book of Coxeter, Revise It in Geometry, Geometry Revise It. So there is a nice example how pencils of cycles can represent geometrical property classically. Next, we utilize the representation of cycles by two times two matrices by considering some invariants of two times two matrices which are determinant and trace. Trace was already related trace of these cycles represent something related to the center. And that if we will take a center, so trace will be second element here. So trace of this matrix, it's this one previous slide. Trace of this matrix is related to the second component of the center of cycle as in the usual geometrical sense. And if we take another invariant of two times two matrix, which is determinant, that will be the second component of foci. There are three different types of foci associated to each cycle. We will see their usage later. So finally, we, on the previous lecture, consider it the different notions of zero radius cycles with a cycle with zero determinant, and this cycle with zero determinant has certain geometrical properties, and that geometrical properties are nicely connected between three different faces which cycle may take, either as circle or as parabolas or hyperbolas. In every case, we have something like tangent property to the real line. It's just manifest itself in all three cases. So this is revision of a previous lecture. Let us now see the main reason why we have introduced these 2 × 2 matrices in order, so with 2 × 2 matrices in order to represent cycle. So the main argument in favor of such representation is the following theorem, which say what we can linearize a fractional linear transformation. So linear fractional transformation, Möbius transformation, which we have obtained as an action of cell to R on corresponding homogeneous spaces. that action is not linear, so we have a fraction here, but if we will think in terms of points and how cycles are transformed, the answer initially can be rather confusing. So say, assume we have a certain circle on the plane and a certain matrix, say transformations with unit determinant. So assume we have that simple matrix cosine pi over 6, sine pi over 6 minus sine pi over 6, cosine pi over 6. So assume we have such a matrix and certain given circle. We want to calculate the image of this circle under Möbius transformation. So we know what this matrix define linear fractional transformation. So a straightforward approach based just on what we know so far will be as follow. We pick up 3 points, arbitrary 3 points on our cycle. So it just again common knowledge from elementary geometry what 3 distinct point define unique cycle. So and look for the Möbius transformation of these 3 points. So somehow we may explicitly calculate it. What will be images of these 3 points under corresponding Möbius transformation, and then for 3 points which are images of our points, we may build a circle which pass with 3 points, and then just try to find out an equation of this circle. So as you see, straightforward procedure based just on linear fractional transformation does not look simple. And so if I initially have parameters K, L, N, M for my initial circle, what will be the corresponding value with parameter for the new circle. So it does not look like an easy and attractive calculation to find out new parameters until we have this theorem. So that theorem tells us what actually calculation of parameter of a new circle can be found from matrix representation. So we take the matrix which represent our circle. This is matrix C. Then we just make matrix conjugation with the matrix which define Möbius transformation. That will be again a 2 × 2 matrix. Some simple calculation shows what that will be again a matrix of the same type. What is the same type? That means what we have real entries on off diagonal position, so this shall be real, and the diagonal elements will be connected by the simple relation what second on diagonal elements is the minus complex conjugate of the first one. So we take complex conjugation and inverse sign. So we have a matrix of this type, and any matrix of this type can be treated as collecting coefficient K, L, N, M for some cycle. So it's easy calculation what matrix conjugation preserves the form of our cycle. So we can, after evaluating that matrix, again decompose it into coefficient K, L, N, M and get the equation of the image of the cycle. So as you can see, this is rather straightforward direct calculation, which easily can be done, say, by computer algebra system. So, by the way, there is a certain software which I am developing for many years. right now, we are finalizing graphical user interface for this software, but previously it was very functional to use it from the interpreter, Python. It's possible to get usage of this software from the coding in this programming language. But very soon it will be also easy to use this software through the certain mouse clicks. So some additional videos about software usage and proving theorem using this software will be posted on the web as well. So actually, in this way, we link our consideration of Erlangen program in the spirit of Felix Klein with the Cartesian approach to geometry, when a geometrical question is reduced to a certain amount of algebraic manipulation with equations. So that language allow us, and algebraic language allow us to find a quick, efficient, and automatic proof of many theorem from the geometry. Now, coming back to the this structure of cycles as being points or vectors in three-dimensional projective space, I recall what we considered them as projective vector space where linear combinations are possible. So besides of linear structure, we can also introduce a certain inner product on this space. That inner product is given by the following expression. So that expression actually is has a simple structure. So in order to find inner product of two cycles, we take matrices which represent these cycles. So C and C tilde. These matrices C and C tilde can be multiplied. Result will be again 2 times 2 matrix. For this matrix, we are taking trace and then real part of this trace. So one of the remarkable property of trace to be one of the matrix invariant under matrix conjugation. So properties of the trace, which we want to recall, is what trace of AB is equal to the trace of BA, although product of matrices AB and BA are different, they have the same trace. And next property is invariance under matrix conjugation, trace of MAM inverse will be the same as trace of A, of matrix A. So that invariance under conjugation is the key reason why inner product is introduced in this way, because it's easy to see what this inner product is invariant under Möbius transformation. Indeed, if we have two cycles, C and C tilde, and a Möbius transformation M which send them to new cycle C prime C tilde prime with the relation what C prime is M C M inverse. Then for inner product, we see what product of C prime tilde will be is just real part of the trace M C prime M C M inverse times M C tilde M inverse according to action of the according to the action of Möbius transformation on cycles in the matrix form. Here we have nice cancellation in the middle, and then we have real part of trace M C prime C tilde prime M inverse. Then invariance of trace with respect to matrix conjugation tell us what we have real part of trace C no prime here, right? So it's no prime in this place. Just C here. C C tilde, which is the inner product of C C tilde. So Möbius transformation act on the cycles in such a way what inner product is preserved. And then what we have here as an inner product, we actually need to make a warning what this is not positively defined inner product. So it's easier to find an explicit form in term of coefficients. So here it's given in term of coefficients for the component of a cycle C and C tilde. It's not positively defined. So we have here not only pluses, but also minuses. And again, brief sigma can be equal to minus one. And then here the component, which is K tilde M plus M tilde K, this is again a skew symmetric product, so it's also make not altogether, it make not positively defined in determinant quadratic form. So there is interesting geometry of this type of spaces, spaces with such indefinite metric, and in such spaces with indefinite metric, it's still is interesting to consider the inner product and the condition which look like orthogonality. That means what inner product of two cycles is equal to zero. So that orthogonality condition is worth to consider, and next slide will show it in geometrical interpretation. So what we want again to highlight once more what this inner product is also connected to the second, although it's defined through the first invariant of two times two matrices with respect to matrix conjugation. It's easy to get the second invariant which is determinant from the same inner product. So if we take inner product of a cycle itself, so then it's again easy to see what this formula for inner product, which we have here explicitly for the cycle multiplier to itself, just produce the determinant of corresponding matrix, minus two times determinant of corresponding matrix. So this is what we get here. So in particular, when it's worth to link it or see it again, what condition of a cycle to be orthogonal to itself means that determinant of corresponding matrix is equal to zero. And since determinant of corresponding matrix is equal to zero, that was already considered as zero radius cycle in our course. So zero radius cycle, another illustration for them, will be self-orthogonal cycles, cycles which are orthogonal to itself. Sometimes it's called isotropy cycles, cycles isotropic one. So how does it look like geometrically when we are considering as corresponding orthogonality for different cycles? Just again remind one more. What we have several parameters in our representation of a cycles by 2×2 matrix. So it's, if it's of importance for us, we put corresponding symbols S and brief sigma here to the cycle to highlight which S parameter S here and which brief iota are used to form our cycle. Of course, if we will make corresponding arrangements, then that value, that inner product will take a different values. Just a reminder, what we will need on the next slide is the Heaviside function. So this is the function which actually act as a sign of a real number. For non-negative real number, it have take value plus one. For negative numbers, it take value minus one. So let us look on the orthogonality condition. So orthogonality condition as it specified before with the wet inner product to equal to zero. So we have different possibilities. Let us first consider, or we mainly will consider the case where our cycles are circles. So geometry of the point space is elliptic, but geometry of the cycle space can be of any three possible types. So it's elliptic, parabolic, or hyperbolic in the inner product. Which we are taking here. So brief sigma can take three different values. So our cycles look like a circles, and the pleasant property for the elliptic geometry in the cycle space where brief sigma also take value minus one, what orthogonality condition take just normal geometrical sense. So if we define orthogonality of cycles as vectors in this in indefinite inner product space, projective space of three dimensions, which you said before, then their realization as circles on the elliptic plane will be just orthogonal in usual sense. So we have here the picture with red cycle here drawn and a collection of families of other cycles which are orthogonal to themselves, which are orthogonal to this red cycle. So orthogonality here understood in geometrical terms, that means tangent line at the intersection point became orthogonal. So if we have a look on orthogonal cycles, then in intersection point, we have here tangent line, green and blue straight lines, which are perpendicular to the red cycle, and they are intersecting in the center of cycles, of course. So two straight line orthogonal to the red cycle intersect in its center. So what will happen with this geometrical picture if we will put, say, parabolic geometry to the space of cycles? So our cycles is still circle, we look in elliptic one, but behavior is different. So if we will look on the point B here, which is intersection which belongs to the red cycle, and we'll draw the collection of blue cycles which passing this point B on the red cycle and will be orthogonal to red cycle in parabolic sense, when we will see what they do not have any common tangent line anymore. So there is no common tangent line to them. So they do that orthogonality condition is not represented in local terms, so we just cannot say what they are orthogonal in the usual geometrical sense. But we will notice what all cycles, which are blue cycles, which passing point B and orthogonal to the red cycle, they will pass again another point, D. So this is what happened. So another point D will appear as the common point of this pencil of cycles. Actually, again, this is one of illustration here. You can see this is like this type of pencil of cycles which pass to common points. So this collection of blue cycles which are orthogonal to the red one and passing point B, they just make such a pencil similar to pencils considered before. We may take point B and try to push it toward point D and see what happened. And this is with our point A here. So this is the point which have that double collection of common tangents. So here the green family of cycle is also orthogonal to the red one. It's pass a single point A, and they all have a common tangent line. So this is family just as on the first picture on the left. So we have a similar green family here, but this time point A does not belong to the red cycle. If we will look on all such points with this property, what cycles passing point A having common tangent line, we will notice what cycles with this property, with point A's with this property, form a certain circle. That circle is presented here by dashed one, by dashed drawing, and we will see, and we see what this dashed circle, which I called ghost circle here, it has common roots with the red circle. So it's common roots, and its center belong to the real axis. This is how geometry orthogonality in parabolic cycle space represented in the elliptic point space. And finally, let us look what happened if our geometry in the cycle space is just hyperbolic one. The picture will be rather similar to the previous parabolic one. Again, points on the red, points B on the red cycle define a pencil of orthogonal blue cycles which do not have a common tangent line, but they have another common point D. So in the same way, and collection of points A which define a pencil orthogonal to the red cycle and having a common tangent line, that collection of points A form again a ghost cycle, dashed one here. This time its center C is just a reflection of the center of red cycle in the real axis. Now, if we will come back to the definition of three type of centers for cycles, we say what there is elliptic, parabolic, and hyperbolic center of cycles. We will see what actually all times ghost cycle has a center, its elliptic center coincide with either elliptic, parabolic, or hyperbolic center of the red cycle. So this is the first property which we have here. So sigma center of Gauss cycle correspond to the elliptic center of the red cycle. And other property, besides knowing the center of this Gauss cycle, we also need to know its radius. And radius is defined by the condition what determinant for this cycle in term of parameter sigma and parameter s being 1 and Heaviside function of brief sigma is calculated as follows. In particular, a consequence of this is that this Gauss cycle and red cycle has common roots. So they intersect real axis in the same points, as we can see on all three pictures. So this is how orthogonality of cycles, which we have discussed here in term of inner product on matrices, is manifest themselves in geometrical terms. So it's rather consistent representation. It's rather compact conditions which describe that geometrical orthogonality. Probably I will not stay longer on the corresponding hyperbolic and parabolic pictures, so we may take these two types of geometries on the point space, so hyperbolic and parabolic, so that will be just pictures with the similar pictures with a similar structure. So we have here a red cycle, in this case it's red hyperbola, and for this red hyperbola we are drawing the corresponding pencils of orthogonal cycles. So these pencils are drawn in two pencils, blue and green. The blue pencil is defined by a point B, which belong to the red cycle, and all cycles in the that blue family pass another second point D then, and we will learn relation between points B and D later. They coincide in the case, so they coincide in the case B is equal to D, so B is the same as D, if geometry of the point space is just the same as the geometry of the cycle space. In this case, they shall be both hyperbolic one. If this is not the case, B and D are different. B and D are different. And in this case, it will be, again, we soon learn it's related to the transformation of inversion in this red cycle. And if we will look for the green family, such that all cycles in this green family pass the same point A and have common tangent line in this point A, then we will see what with all such points A with this property, which defines such pencils, belong to another Gauss cycles, again, with the same property, with relation to the center. It's this time that Gauss cycles is hyperbola, and center is just in the same relation, and roots of red and dashed cycles are again coincide. So just the same previous theorem which we have on the previous slide, is satisfied. So that theorem which we have on the previous slide, it satisfies in all nine type of geometries which we have here, three type of point geometry times three times of three different types of cycle geometry. I wish to highlight here a bit the notion of orthogonality in hyperbolic space, because it's related to space-time geometry in relativity in physical terms. So that relation is given by this formula here. So let us discuss how this happened. So actually, to see that origin of this type of orthogonality, again, here, if you look on point A on this picture, so we said what green family of cycles here orthogonal to the red one, and it's not orthogonal in the sense of Euclidean geometry, it's orthogonal in the Minkowski space sense. So how to understand it? So in Euclidean space, so Euclidean inner product between two vectors say vector A and A dash is given by U times U prime plus V V prime. So orthogonality correspondingly means what we have U U prime plus V V prime is equal to zero. And then in terms of the corresponding slopes of our vectors, we came to the conclusion what U over V is equal minus 1 U over U prime over V prime. So this is orthogonality in Euclidean space. So if we have vectors here where slopes have this relation, which we shall already know from some analytical geometry consideration. So Minkowskian geometry the inner product between vectors here is given by hyperbolic type of inner products, so it's have minus sign here, and relation between slopes when for orthogonal vectors will be U divided by V is equal, so with plus sign U prime V prime. So just reciprocal with the same sign. How does it's geometrically represented? So we have Minkowski space-time. And if we have here vector A, we draw through endpoint of this vector the corresponding light cone, so with the slopes 45 degrees, then orthogonal vector A will have just the same angle here with the light cone. So this is light cone or null cone in the space-time geometry. So this is orthogonality relation which shall happen. So angle between two vectors in hyperbolic space is bisected by the lines from the light cone. So this is how orthogonality works. And if you will pay a closer attention here to this picture of orthogonality which we have in hyperbolic space, if you draw here the tangent lines to the red cycle and green cycle, then you will see what they are orthogonal just in this sense. Light cone here, light cone, if we will draw on this picture light cone, it will be just bisecting angle between tangent line at point A. So this is that orthogonality in the Minkowski space-time, which we will see also on several further occasions. Finally, we may proceed with parabolic situation. So in parabolic situation, we have exactly the same orthogonality condition, where the same theorem is still applicable, but with time our cycles, so the same theorem, which six, but cycles are now I have hyperbolas, and orthogonality condition here just means what our tangent lines are orthogonal to the vertical line. So what happened here? Orthogonality in parabolic case, similarly, if we will draw that will be called Galilean space-time geometry. So we have two vectors, a prime, and just as before, if we will see the Euclidean inner product with plus, hyperbolic inner product, Minkowski inner product with minus, in parabolic case, Galilean case, it came just zero, the middle value. So orthogonality condition or inner product became like that, and orthogonality condition is OO prime is equal to zero, and geometrically that means one vector shall be vertical. So this is kind of orthogonality which we have, and here that orthogonal vectors which are vertical are given by dotted vertical lines. So that kind of degenerate parabola. So how that degenerate parabola appears? So just imagine what we have two given points, and we are trying to draw parabolas through with passing these two points with the decreasing focal length. Eventually, after we push focal length to the zero, that parabolas will degenerate to two vertical lines. So two vertical lines is just a degenerated form of a parabola with zero focal line passing two points. So this is presented here by dotted pictures. So and when corresponding inner product here, corresponding orthogonality is given by this identity. So this is kind of orthogonality which we have obtained in parabolic space. Probably I will better to stop lecture at this point, and on the next lecture we will move to the relation between points B and D with respect to this orthogonality on previous pictures and corresponding notion of the inversion in a cycle. Are there any questions? Okay, thank you for coming, and please don't forget to mark your attendance.